If you are looking at a Janome MC9450 and wondering what accessories come with it, you're going to want to watch this video because I'm going to take you through them all. If you are not already a subscriber to my YouTube channel, please subscribe and be sure to hit the bell so you'll get notified the next time I have a new video. Hi, I'm Kim from Chatterbox Quilts. In today's video, I want to show you the accessories that come with the Janome MC9450. Whether you're a quilter or a garment sewer or do other kinds of sewing, I'm sure you're going to find an accessory that'll work for you with this machine. So let's take a look. First off, you have some of the things that you're going to need to maintain your machine, or if you're unfortunate enough that you need to use this little guy ripping out seams. So, seam ripper. There's a little cleaner here, a little brush to get into that bobbin area or other parts of the machine to clean. And of course, your little screwdriver, because you're going to need that to take your feet on and off the machine. And you always want to make sure that your feet are tightened up when you're stitching with the machine. All right, so let's move these out of the way for now. And let's talk about the bottom part of the machine, as it were. You get needle plates. So with the Janome 9450, you get an HP needle plate. And this works with the HP foot, which you see here. Now, this foot is going to give you a very accurate quarter inch seam. And I love this combination when I'm piecing my quilt tops. In addition to the HP needle plate and the foot that goes with that, you have two other needle plates. Now, I want to bring this over and show you here because I love how they store. This part, this storage part, goes around the bed of your sewing machine. And there are storage areas in it, as you can see. And there are little trays that come out in more storage area underneath. But what I really want to show you right now is how you can store these needle plates. So there's actually some little tabs in here, and you can actually put the needle plates right in those little tabs. So when you're not using them, you can put them in there. And I have two of them. And when they're in there, this part will still fit on the bed of your sewing machine. So that's really handy. Now, what do you get here? Well, you've got your regular needle plate that you're going to use for when you're doing any kind of decorative stitches or zigzags. And you also get this needle plate, which is your single hole needle plate. So this is what I like to use when I'm free motion quilting. And they fit in there very nicely. Now, what else do you get? Well, you get some spool holders. So you have some small spool holders here, and you have a large one, so you can use bigger thread spools, or cones, I should say, on your machine, or smaller ones. So depending on the size of that thread spool, you will use the appropriate little spool holder. And then, of course, there's an awful lot of feet that come with this. So let's talk about some of the feet. First off, you're going to see this on the machine. This is your A foot, your kind of regular foot you'd use for regular stitching. Okay, so if you're a garment sewer, you may use this just to sew the seams of your garment together. As a quilter, I don't use it all that often. But it's very handy for generic sewing, if you will. As a quilter, though, some of the feet I really enjoy are these two here. So this is your quarter inch foot, and it has a guide on it. So some people like to use that. They prefer to have that little guide that stands proud of the foot to do their quarter inch piecing. Or if they prefer to have it without the guide, it's the same foot, it just doesn't have the guide on it here. Oh, and by the way, I should just mention to you, when you're putting the majority of these feet on or off, you have this holder here. So the holder has a part at the back that you press in, and it will release your foot. To put them back on, you just snap them in at the front, just like that. Makes it really easy to take the feet on and off of the holder. All right, what else would I like to use? Well, I like to do applique. And when I'm finishing the edges of my applique, I will use one of these two feet, the F or F2 foot. The F foot is what you call a closed one, and this one is an open satin stitch foot. And they're both clear, but sometimes I like to use the F2 foot. And actually in my videos, you'll often see me using the F2 foot just so it's easier for my viewers to see what I'm doing. Now let's get into some free motion quilting. For free motion quilting, we have these two feet, PDH feet. One, as you can see, is closed and one is open. I like to use the open one, that's this one here, because it has this open area here, which gives me better visibility. But you need to be a little bit careful because the fact that it's open means that these little parts here might get stuck on threads. So you just need to be a little careful on that. Again, it's just your preference, but I love how Janome gives you those two options. Then we get into more free motion quilting feet with these little guys. So we have the QC or QO, so the free motion quilting closed foot, or the free motion quilting open foot. Just more options for you. And then we have this QZ foot, which is for the variable zigzag, because you can do that on the Janome MC9450. Or you have this zigzag foot as well. So if you're doing free motion quilting, especially around applique, this is a great foot. This little dish shape here means it comes up to, but kind of glides over the applique. So you don't have to worry about the part of the foot getting caught on your applique stitching. Wow, lots of feet, right? It's great because there's so many different applications where I use a variety of these feet. Then we come to two of my favorite feet that come with this machine. We have the AccuFeed Flex foot here. This is your regular AccuFeed Flex foot that comes with a lot of the Janome machines, this AD foot. So I like to use this for putting on bindings or putting on borders. But new with this machine is this HP2 AccuFeed Flex foot. So much like the HP foot that I showed you earlier, it's going to work with that HP needle plate, but it has also the capability of a walking foot, or using the AccuFeed Flex system on the Janome MC9450. So this is really my preferred foot now for putting on borders or binding, because I want that accurate quarter inch seam, which it gives me, and I want to use that AccuFeed Flex system that's going to feed both the top and bottom layers through together on the machine. And I should point out this little guy, which some people are probably wondering, what is that thing for? Well, it's very handy when using either one of these AccuFeed Flex feet, because you can see there's little holes at the back. I shouldn't say at the back here. Sorry, there's holes. There's lots of holes. It's this little hole here. And what happens is this will go right in it. And sometimes you have to push a little bit. I haven't tried this yet on this foot, actually. So it's a little stiff, but that's okay, because I want to be able to push it to a certain place and use it as a guide. So let's say, for example, I am doing straight line quilting on my quilt, and I want to have the quilting lines this from the needle here to here that far apart. I can use my quilting guide here, put it in, adjust it to where I want it, and then this is going to run along my previous line of stitching, making that a perfect distance every time as I go along my quilt. Really love this quilting guide. It's so helpful. All right, so that's the majority of things I use as a quilter. But if you're a garment sewer, there are more feet for you. So let's take a look at this one first. I'm sure if you're a garment sewer, you're going to recognize this. This is your buttonhole foot. It has a stabilizer plate underneath it as well. It also comes with an additional part that you may need to use when you're making buttonholes as well. I'm not a buttonhole making kind of person for the majority of my time, but I know that you have the ability to make a variety of buttonholes using these pieces, these accessories, I should say, on the Janome MC9450. So if you are a garment sewer, you are covered for making buttonholes. Then we have other feet. Oh, I forgot a foot is a quilter that I like to use. The ruler, the QR foot, the ruler quilting foot. So when I'm doing free motion quilting but using rulers, this is the foot for me. And it is thicker than other feet. That allows you to run it along the quilting rulers. And it has a little divot in the front, a little cutout there, which gives you better visibility. This foot works so well. I have used it many, many times with rulers to quilt my quilts. All right, here comes more. This is for you garment sewers out there. Now, if you're a garment sewer and you want to sew your buttons on your garment, you have this little foot, T. That is your button sewing foot. And so you can use that to actually sew the buttons on by machine and not by hand. Then you have these feet here. So this is your over edge foot, foot number M. This is your blind hemming foot. And then you have your rolled hem foot. So all very helpful feet to have if you're a garment sewer, for sure. All right, so lots and lots of feet and accessories that come with this machine. It's great, but then you go, what am I gonna do with them? Well, we've got you covered there too. So we come back to this piece of equipment here, this storage case that goes around the bed of your machine. And I told you it opens up. So you have storage on either side, and look, there's more things in here. Okay, I have a cloth guide here. Let me move this out of the way for a moment. So this cloth guide fits in around the bed of your machine, and you can move it back and forth. So much like the machine quilting guide that I showed you earlier here, the quilt guide, You can use this, and it's got this part that's raised, and you would put your fabric against it. You would adjust it to where you want it, put your fabric against it, and then you can sew along and get that same width from your needle to this part of the cloth guide. Very helpful as well. And you saw that it fit in this area perfectly. Then I have this, so you can put your feet in here if you want. I have bobbins in here right now. Just never ends, eh? Look at all the storage in here. Then you have your vertical spool pin as well here to hold bigger spools of thread if you want, or if you want to have them in a different orientation than what the machine has already built in. It's just like a treasure hunt here, isn't it? And then of course the machine comes with some needles, but you can keep your needles in here too. So I like to have different packages of different needle sizes and types. It's a great place to keep them in here. What I love about all this storage is how things fit in so neatly. It takes me a while to figure them out sometimes where they all go, but they all do fit in neatly. Like for example, this one I always have to struggle with, although I know it goes in there really well the other way though. There we go. It's me, not the storage container. And then you can put this on top. So if I have more feet, I can put them here too. So the nice thing about these various storage containers is that there's extra space in them should I buy more accessories or feet. And you know that's going to happen, right? Okay, let's move that over to the side. And it also comes with this box. Now, this is where the majority of my feet tend to rest when I'm not using them. Again, all kinds of places to put foot holders, and you've got these bigger areas which hold the AccuFeed Flex, it's hard to say sometimes, the AccuFeed Flex feet very easily. Where's my other little guy? Here he is. But this comes off too, so you can take that off, and you have more storage down here. So I can put things like my button holder in the center there, that fits in there, and all the other feet, everything will fit in here. And in addition to these boxes, or these storage containers, the machine itself, when I open up the lid on it, there is also space for a few more feet in there too. So I love how there is all this storage space. I love all the accessories, of course, but I gotta say, having the place to store these accessories is so critical, because think about it. You know, if you buy extra accessories and you have to carry them around plastic bags or other boxes, it gets hard to even find them. So I love having them like this. If you're taking your machine out to retreat or even just using it at home, you don't want to have feet all over the place. You want them all safely stored. So with the Janome MC9450, you get these great storage options as well as all the accessories I showed you. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up and be sure to share it with your quilting friends. And if you are interested in finding out more content about quilting, you may want to take a look at my paid private membership group called The Quilter's Way. And you can find it at thequiltersway.com.